93,000 plus in attendance at the Pontiac Silverdome, this was WrestleMania 3. All kinds of records were set, as this was the pinnacle for the World Wrestling Federation as a leading company in sports entertainment, and I'll be referring to them as this name for the entirety of the video. The WWF and wrestling in general was kind of a big deal in my childhood. Went to live shows, and sometimes even dressed up as wrestlers. It was something that I could look forward to on a weekly basis. The characters, the storylines, the good guys, and the guys you love to hate. It was all for entertainment. And that's right, I said entertainment. Back then, you didn't know any better, and you thought it was all real. But we all know it's just for show now. Although I don't know how you could fake this. Like I was saying, pure entertainment. With an ever-growing fan base, the WWF expanded their brand tenfold with a variety of products. You got your VHS collectible home videos, t-shirts, a monthly magazine, a shitload of action figures, musical CDs with the wrestler's entrance music, and yes, of course, video games. Now I have to admit, some stuff that I pulled out, I don't actually remember playing. There's a card game called Earthquake, and you have these trivia cards. Mr. Perfect was especially proud of his 21-inch what? Oh boy, that sounds bad. Neck. Oh, okay, never mind. Their first attempt at a video game came to the NES with WWF WrestleMania by Acclaim. Around the time of its release, two games had already attempted to create a pro wrestling game. One called Pro Wrestling, which is pretty good for its time. And there was Tecmo World Wrestling, released a year after, also okay. I like the part when you're in training mode and you do push-ups with a sumo wrestler on top. Boy, that's real creative. One thing I always enjoyed was the theme music that the wrestlers entered the ring to. It always gave what the hell am I doing, a history lesson? This is a review. Hit the music! Alright, here's the opening screen. You got an 8-bit rendition of Hulk Hogan ripping his shirt, taken from the boxing cartridge picture, although his rendition in 8-bit looks more like a drunk, potbelly looking hippie. At first glance, I'm amused by the Vegas style lighting, bright colors, there's cool music playing. The slogan reads, bigger, better, badder. Badder? What's badder? Like the shit you use to make pancakes? Okay, I know what they're really trying to say here, but their delivery is awkward. So what kind of wrestlers do we got going for this game? Well, you might be disappointed, as there's only 6 that you can choose from, which I suppose were the 6 most hyped wrestlers at the time of the game's release. Kinda disappointing. There's 2 game modes, Exhibition, which is called Standard, and Tournament Mode, which with one player you have face-to-face with wrestlers in a predetermined order. I'd like to say it's from easiest to hardest. You also have the option to have 6 human players playing head-to-head in the tournament, although I have serious doubts that anyone's ever done this. Oh yeah, you get to put your name in, which is kind of pointless if you're only playing one player. Well, here goes nothing. The gameplay centers inside the ring, and this is the only setting in the entire game. Well, it's not much to complain about since that's what you'd expect. Now the object, if it's not obvious already, is to beat your opponent. And when I say beat, that's pretty much literally what you're gonna do. The only moves that can be performed are striking moves of punches and kicks, the A button being a punch and B for kicks. There's no wrestling type moves at all. No throwing opponents into the ropes. And even more disappointing is that there's no grappling, the core essential in any pro wrestling match. Well, for the most part, every wrestler has the same attacks. So that means every match is pretty much a carbon copy of any other match. Now, there are a few unique moves in the game, like running attacks. Bam Bam Bigelow has a cool looking cartwheel move. But that's all it is, it just looks cool. Needless to say, this is probably the most exciting thing in the game. Cartwheels. After further exploring this game, a few other moves I found. This back elbow smash can be quite effective because it can be really quick. But the problem is, you need to have your back to your opponent.
Now that's kind of odd. The most effective move is when your back is to an opponent? Huh.
And they sure don't make it easy on you. To elbow smash, you need to push both the A and B buttons at the same time, which is frickin' hard. My technique is to use the index and middle fingers, but even this doesn't work good. When I want to elbow smash, it ends up punches and kicks instead, and I look like an idiot.
Now, what a piece of crap.
The Nintendo doesn't need to worry about pushing two buttons to elbow smash. Much like in some fighting games, where you need to memorize a sequence of buttons to perform one move, while the computer just does them. A disadvantage I always hated.
Your energy is in the top left corner, tallied by bars, much like in Mega Man. Obviously, when you land hits, the computer's energy will decrease. But what's really frustrating is that your energy also decreases when you attack. Now granted, I know it takes energy to take a swing at somebody, but the whole thing just seems counterproductive. To gain energy, simply avoid getting hit as your life will charge slowly. Or you can collect these special energizer icons that just magically appear at the top of the ring.
I can't even tell what the hell they're supposed to be. What is that, a piece of pizza for Andre? On closer inspection, it's actually a Bigfoot imprint. Now that's creative.
They only give one or two tabs of energy, so they're pretty much useless. Now, what's the most important thing to do in a match? Well, that's winning the match. And because you can't throw the opponent to the outside for a countout, or apply a submission for a tapout, the only way of winning is by pinfall. You first have to get the computer on the ground. Now, when you knock him on the ground and he still has energy, he springs right back up, like fresh and new, like nothing happened. So the only way to get the computer down long enough for a pin, their energy has to be completely empty. Now, this is where the game gets plain retarded. When your opponent's on the ground, you can't do any moves to him. There's no special type moves you can do, like an elbow dive or a leg drop. So you'd think to pin, it'd be pretty simple. A or B, but no, that'd be too simple. Like, the hardest part in the game shouldn't be figuring out how to pin somebody. God bless. Now, just look at this. Does it like it's nothing? Ugh, that's bullshit. At first, I'm just stubborn. You know, I'll figure it out. It can't be that hard. But slowly and surely, I just start mashing the buttons together out of pure frustration. At last resort, I have to pause the game mid-match and search the instruction booklet for some answers. Okay, according to this performance chart, I guess they have a list of different wrestlers' moves here. And according to this, pin is A plus up and down. No, wait a minute, it's B plus up and down. Oh my god, pin is different for the different characters. Whose brainiac idea was this? Okay, so say I'm Hulk Hogan and I want a pin. It would be B plus up and down. What, do I press B before or during up and down? Ugh, making me sick. Just pin. Thank God. Well, I wish that's all I had to say about this game, but unfortunately, they made this tournament mode.